customizing shapes in Creative Cloud Express. Stick around. Hello everyone and welcome. My name is Claudio. So glad that you're here. If you are a first-time visitor, thanks so much for stopping by. Consider subscribing, liking this video, and clicking the bell to be notified for future videos. If you are returning, thank you so much for stopping by once again, and you could also do all those things as well. In today's video, I'm going to walk you through how you can customize shapes, which were formerly known as icons, in Creative Cloud Express. So let's go ahead and dive right in. Starting off at express.adobe.com, I'm going to start a brand new project by clicking on the plus sign here and choose custom size graphic. I'll go ahead and click on next for the default for this example. And one of the first things I want to do is change the background color just so it's visible for you. I'll go ahead and choose a light gray here. There we go. And now what we're going to do is look for the shapes. Over here on the left-hand side, you'll see the menu options. And here, shapes, which was formerly labeled as icons, now you see it's labeled shapes and shows there add shapes and icons. So what I'm going to show you is how you can now, with shapes, adjust the border along with what's the inside color. So let's go ahead and do that. Now we'll go ahead and choose more here for basic shapes. So if you're creating something for a lesson and you want to use shapes, let's say for a rectangle, I'll go ahead and click there. Well, with these basic shapes, you can customize the color of the border as well as the inside or the body of the shape. So I'll go ahead and click on this square. And if you see over here on the right-hand side where it shows edit shape, you have the fill, which I called the body, and then you have a border. So let's go ahead and turn on the border. Right now, the border color is white. You can see there. Oh, let's go ahead and change the color of the border. I'll use one of my custom colors there. And then the fill, I'll go ahead and click where it says fill, and I'll go ahead and choose this light blue color. So there we have that shape with my custom color border as well as custom color fill. You'll be able to do this with your basic shapes that will have a fill and a border. So let's go ahead and go back to shapes here. We're still within the basic shapes. So let's scroll down here. Say, for example, let's look at flowers. So I'll go ahead and choose this flower here. So we have that flower with a fill and a border. We'll go ahead and change the colors out. Let's go with, let's click on more and let's go with an orange. And then our fill, let's go ahead and make the fill a darker orange. So there we go. So you can do that again with shapes that will have a fill and a border. So as you go through your basic shapes here, here we have a smiley face. There you have the option to change the fill and a border. Here we have some miscellaneous shapes, happy, sad faces, musical notations, moons. Let's go back to basic shapes here. We have speech bubbles. If we click on speech bubble, this is really cool. So you can click on a speech bubble and give it a nice border. I'll leave the border as black and I'll change the fill to white. And then you can go ahead and add text to this speech bubble. Really cool. So let's go back to basic shapes. So now let's see how this works with other shapes. So we'll go back to your shapes and we'll exit out of the basic shapes and we'll look at more shapes and see what happens. So we'll click on more shapes and here is a flower. So you'll notice that this flower here only has one color, which is the entire shape. So with this one, I'm only able to adjust the entire color. So it does not have a fill or border. So just be aware of that as you go through here. Your basic shapes will give you more options to adjust or customize the border as well as the fill. And then when you come back to your other shapes here, these will pretty much just be a solid color. Just be aware as you work with shapes, some of them will have fills and borders while others will have solid colors. And that's how you can customize shapes in Creative Cloud Express. And now it's your turn to give it a try. If you have any comments or questions about this video, please do drop it in the comment section below. Don't forget, like, subscribe, click the bell to be notified for future videos, and please do share this video with your friends. Thanks again for stopping by, and as always, be good to one another.